Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. Today's topic is rickets. But before starting this topic, I would like to request you to like, subscribe and share these videos to support this channel, you know. And if you need more information about any disease or any medical condition, you know, you can visit my website, which is www.diseasesandtreatment.com, you know. And the click for the website is just below this video in the description area, so you can click that link to visit the website. Now I come to the topic, what is rickets? You know, rickets is a skeletal disorder that is caused by the lack of vitamin D, you know, calcium and phosphate. And these nutrients are important for the development of the strong and healthy bones, you know. And the people with the rickets may have weak and the soft bones, stunted growth, and in severe cases, maybe the skeletal deformities, you know. And the vitamin B, vitamin D, it helps to the body to absorb the calcium and phosphate from the intestines, you know. And you can get the vitamin D from various food products, including milk, eggs, and fish, you know. And your body also produces a vitamin B when it is exposed to the sunlight, you know. But if you are living in a country where you don't see the sun too much, you know, in that case, you may need the vitamin B D supplements, you know. And vitamin B deficiency makes it difficult for your body to maintain the sufficient levels of calcium and phosphate, you know. And when this occurs, your body produces hormone that causes the calcium and the phosphate to be released from your bones, you know. And when your bones lack these minerals, they become weak and they become soft, you know. And the rickets is the most common in children who are between the age of 6 to 36 months, which means that 6 months to 3 years, you know. And the children are at the highest risk of rickets because they are still growing. And the children might not get enough vitamin B if they live in the region with a little sunlight, you know. And they are following the vegetarian diet and they don't drink milk products, you know. In some cases, the children, they inherit this condition, you know. Rickets used to be more common. But it's rare now, but it's mostly disappeared in the developed countries during the 1940s, you know. But you can still see the cases in the developing countries, you know. And the risk factors for the rickets include like the age, maybe the diet, maybe the skin color, geographic location, and the genes, you know. So the rickets is most common in children who are between the age of 6 and 36 months, you know. And during this time, after the period, the children usually experience a rapid growth, you know, and they need more calcium, more phosphate, you know, to strengthen their bones, you know. Okay, and you have a higher risk of developing the rickets if you eat a vegetarian diet only, you know. That does not include fish, eggs or milk, you know. And you're also at the increased risk if you have trouble digesting milk. You have the allergy to the lactose, you know. So the infants who are only breastfed can become deficient in the vitamin D as well as the so the breast milk does not contain enough vitamin D to prevent the rickets, you know. So you need to get from any other source. And the children of the African Pacific Islanders or the Middle Eastern descent are at high risk of the rickets disease, you know, because they have the dark skin, you know. And dark skin does not react as strongly to the sunlight as a lighter skin does, you know. So it produces less vitamin D. And our bodies produce more vitamin D when they are exposed to sunlight. So you are more at risk for the rickets if you live in the area with the little sunlight, you know. And you're also at a high risk if you work indoors during the daylight hours, you know. And one of the rickets can be inherited, you know. So this means that this disorder is passed through your genes, you know. And this type of rickets called hereditary calcium, and it prevents your kidneys from absorbing the phosphate. Now, the next thing is about the symptoms, you know. Well, these may include like pain, the tenderness in the bones of the arms, of the legs, pelvis, and spine, you know. Stunted growth and short stature, you know. Bone fractures, muscle cramps, teeth deformity such as delayed tooth formation or maybe holes in the enamel, you know. Abscesses, defects in the tooth structure, and an increased number of cavities, you know. And the skeletal deformities may include like oddly shaped skull, bow legs, other legs that bow out, you know, bumps in the rib cage, protruding breastbone, curved spine, and maybe the pelvic deformities, you know. And you should call your doctor right away if your child is showing these signs of the recurrence for the further evaluation. And if that this disorder is not treated during the child's growing age, you know, the child may need, may end up with a very short stature as an adult, you know. So it need to be detected and diagnosed at the early stage, so the child have enough time to go for the treatment, you know. Your doctor may be able to diagnose the recurrence by performing the physical examination, and they will check the for any tenderness or the pain in the bones, lightly pressing the bones, you know. And your doctor may also order the certain tests like blood tests and bone X-rays, etc., you know, to see any deformities. And in rare cases, the bone biopsy may be needed, you know. And this involves the removal of a small piece or a section of bone, you know, which will be sent to lab to see under the microscope by a pathologist, you know. Now, once diagnosed, then the treatment focuses on replacing the missing vitamin and the mineral in the body, you know. And they will eliminate most of the symptoms associated with the recurrence. And if your child has vitamin D deficiency, you know, your doctor will likely want them to increase their exposure to sunlight. And they will also encourage them to consume the food products high in vitamin D, like milk or eggs or fish and liver, you know. And calcium and the vitamin D, it strengthens the bones, you know. So the supplements will be used to treat the rickets. And as your doctor plans, you know, just follow the instructions and ask your doctor if you have any questions about the dosage. Okay. And too much vitamin D and the calcium can be unsafe as well, you know. So follow-up treatment appointments are very important to attend, you know. And the skeletal deformities are present, in that case your child may need the braces to position their bones and correctly and as they grow, you know. And in severe cases your child may need corrective surgery, you know. And for the hereditary recurrence, the combination of the phosphate supplements and the high levels of a special form of the vitamin D are required, you know, to treat the disease. Increasing vitamin D, calcium and the phosphate levels will help to correct the disorder, you know. And the most children will improve in about 1 week, you know. And the skeletal deformities will often improve or disappear over the time. So if the recurrence is corrected while the child is still growing, you know. And the skeletal deformities can become like permanent, you know, if it's left untreated, you know. And if it's not treated during the growing age, you know. And the best way to prevent is to eat a balanced diet, which includes adequate amount of the calcium, the phosphorus, and the vitamin D, you know. And the people with the kidney disorders should have their calcium and phosphate levels monitored on regular basis by their doctors, you know. And it can be prevented by with the moderate sun exposure, balanced diet. It's very helpful. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you need more information about any disease or any medical condition, you can visit my website, which is www.diseasesandtreatment.com. And please do not forget to like, subscribe, or share these videos. Thank you very much. Goodbye.